seeing a bit of Jono's hair colour in that,
have
that
I?
Graphic. A little bit of a red, red tinge.
Pretty blonde now.
See?
Lemon juice.
A bit of sun in. Now, it's August 1st today, the last month of winter. Yes. But you've got a nice winter warmer that can get us through the next 30 days.
And it's the easiest, simplest, cheapest meal to do. Mm-hmm. You need two cans...
What is it?
Tuna casserole. Two cans of tuna just in your little dish here. Mm-hmm. And while we're doing this, if Ida, could you put some butter in the... there to make a we're going to make a cheese sauce.
Do you need to grease the pan?
No, no, nothing
like
that.
Pass me a spoon, please. How much butter? All the butter?
Oh, no, that long.
Okay.
That's enough. You can, look, this costs nothing to do, well, something, but it's about $8 or something to do four people. Now, that's cheap, and that's with a salad and some mash.
And I would call those two medium tins of tuna.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Aldi, 167. Now we're going to have a little bit of flour in with that butter.
You're going to make a white sauce. What are we making?
We're making just a white sauce first.
Okay. So a bit of plain flour there.
Plain flour, salt and pepper into there. And then we're going to use some milk. And then we've got our grated cheese.
You want a lot
cheese.
Of sauce or a little bit of sauce?
That's only a little tiny bit. We don't need much. But it is one of the easiest things, excuse I.
So you like to serve this with a bit of mashed tater and
a salad. Mm. But I gave you this when you came to my house the other day.
It was very, very good. I went back for thirds.
But what I'm doing is putting a squeeze of lemon juice on the tuna before we cook it, and I'll have a little bit of salt.
See, I always thought tuna casserole was pasta-based.
Well, it probably is, but not mine.
But
I'm not keen on pasta in that like that.
It's a good way if you wanted to fill the family up and cheaply, you can chuck some pasta in. But you know, if you're trying to avoid that sort of stodgy stuff...
I'll play it up a bit. It's very...
Oh. I can't see without my glasses. Just come over here, please.
What a surprise. This is not working yet again.
No, it's
on.
It's on. All right. Careful you don't get any lumps there, right?
No, I'm going to get rid of them, don't worry.
Mm. Okay, so we're just doing that. Mm-hmm. And then we're I like to put a bit of parsley just in there for a little bit of green. And it's very good for you. It's got all your vitamins and your minerals. Mm. Have you put salt and pepper there?
No, I haven't.
Excuse me.
You were using it when I was preparing.
Oh, sorry.
I didn't like to take it from your hands.
No. I can understand that,
Isaac.
You've got lovely manners.
Thank you so much, yes. So do you. Have a sniff.
How are we going?
We're going well.
Should it be really watery?
Pardon? Should it be that watery?
It'll thicken when
I put
the cheese
in. Give it a break. It's got to get hot before it thickens up, Sarah.
In fact...
we're on a very small hot plate.
Yes, well, there's a bit of a crack in our induction.
It's
coming
now.
Well, that looks good.
Cheers.
Going to throw that in?
Yep.
There, use all of that. That's yummy.
Oh, here
cleaning
we go.
Up. We clean up as we go.
Oh,
look,
fantastic.
We do all our pots like that. Mm-hmm. Don't quite know what that's for. Actually, we'll have a little bit more milk in that.
Yeah, a little bit. Thank you.
There we are. We're a good pair in the kitchen.
We are.
Aren't we?
Mm. Yes, we could start a kitchen, couldn't we?
We're two middle-sized ladies. Remember the two fat ladies?
Oh, no.
Yeah, we'll be two medium ladies.
Did you not think that was the best series?
It was great.
Did you love that?
Yeah, fantastic.
Brilliant. Looking good, Houston. But we did have one we've prepared earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Ta-da!
Oh, wow. Yum. Now, hang on a second.
How did I get from that to that?
Yeah, because that looks much higher.
Well, it's because we accommodated the smaller wackadacker.
Oh, so you'd fill this tray...
With the cheese sauce,
and
then
the panko crumbs,
and then some parsley.
So is this the secret ingredient, the panko crumbs?
The panko crumbs just make it look... Here, have a taste.
Oh, yummy. But I was going to take it with me.
Oh,
for dinner. Oh. Is that all right?
We have to have a taste test, but there's enough there. I'll make another one for you.
Could you?
I think it's right.
Yeah, that's right. That can go over there.
Oh.
On the...
You can take this one.
How is it?
That's yummy.
Are the panko crumbs meant to be uncooked under this?
Hey? Well, that's yum. That is yummy.
That's cooked.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that fab?
There you are. And then we're pankoing.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
And that, oh, panko crumbs, honestly, I just want to kiss the Chinaman, the Chinese man or Japanese man that made these because they're just so delicious.
Well, they've changed my life. No, they have. And
not
my
often
husband's.
You hear that from a woman. So panko crumbs have changed my life.
Can so I take it now?
A bit of parsley. Panko.
Yeah, just because it's good for us, parsley, and it gives a little bit of flavour. There you go. And
how long in the oven?
Oh, well, until it's as brown as that, which is about a half an hour, depends on your oven, half an hour, 40 minutes, depending.
You're one of those annoying chefs that does things by sight and feeling.
I know, I can't help it, but that's...
No, the
vibe of it. Temperature about 180
medium.
In a gas.
Right.
Yeah.
Medium, okay.
All right, that's all right. The tuna casserole.
We are going to put Denise's recipe online so you can cook it up for yourselves at home. There she is.